Morning, everyone. Nicola Russell here. Hope you're having a good Sunday. It's Sunday, the 24th of January. I wanted to come on and just have a little chat about the subject of miscommunication. It's quite interesting, isn't it? It's like Chinese whispers. What happens is that we have our own truths that we sit with. We have our own words that we may use. When different societies and places that we're in, we might sort of find that a word may have a different meaning. So words, the linear words, tend to be misunderstood depending upon your perspective. So, da, si ma ko kranta ishan mo yam a susi kia anna le shanta ele ma kiata. Anna ma hua shono mo ko et ishan anna ma kiata. So when there is a transmission coming down from the universe, it's the same thing as misunderstandings with words that people may use. That anamako krante sian maki onomokai wa shan omakai is dan oma wa shan akai omasha. So the communication level between our guides, our higher self, coming down into the physical form, into a linear language concept, has a slight distortion, a distortion of what they are trying to tell us and what we're picking up with. Now, if there's something in our energy field that is creating this sort of sense of, an emotion coming forward, whatever the emotion might be, when we get the information come down for guidance, we have a distortion of the emotion that's coming through us, that as that energy and that information is coming down as a download, we might then totally get the wrong idea of what they're actually trying to tell us. So they may say one thing and then you're like, oh, it's that. And they're going like, no, that's not what we meant. That creates an experience, but that's always divinely orchestrated too, because the experience will give us an underlining under information. Although we feel we've been, the whole communication has been misplaced, it's not that, it's just that we've misunderstood it because we have a layer of emotion that we need to clear. And the layer of emotion will clear once you recognized through the experience, through the distortion, that you're going to receive the information actually of what it was for in the first place. So when they bring us some information through, the energy that's holding us into the experience that we then create then lifts. Once we've gone through the experience lifts off because we're going through the emotion to enable us to release it. Once we've released it, it enables us to then see what the message was in the first place. Now, this happened to me a couple of days ago, which was quite interesting. I had a download of information that came through. I jumped on it. I jumped on this form of communication. Are you sure? Are you sure? Are you sure? Yes. So I said what I wanted to say. But then after I thought, oh, that's not what I actually meant. That other person then misconstrued what I was saying. Once I had gone through the emotion after what that person had said, I then realized that actually the message was completely different to what actually the message with what was being said. So the same thing was being said, but the understanding was different. The understanding was different. So my ego picked up on something that I was feeding from a mind point of view, and my heart was saying another thing, which was in alignment to the oversoul transmission. I hope this is making sense. What I'm trying to say here is, let's just break it down into an analogy. Can we have an analogy, please? Ma siano ma ko krantale shi siano ma ko krantale shanto lo bora ma kia. It is always the intention that sees through the result. And the intention is always to communicate through the heart. Now, I work with Robert Van Kooten, And you might see some of my lives that I do with him. And he always talks about the heart. Push your hands on your heart, and whatever you communicate will always come through as a truth without the distortion. If you allow yourself to go into the head and see the layer of emotion that is on top of the communication, it will then distort. You step straight into the heart, you put your hand on your heart, then you say those same words. Does it have the same meaning? No, it doesn't. It doesn't have the same meaning. You may not even actually say the same words. It is the distortion with the energy that is hovering over you that is creating that. Okay. They're giving me a picture of a trifle. So in a trifle, you have the layer of the sort of sponge at the bottom with a bit of fruit, a bit of jelly, the custard and the cream. Okay, da. Si yw'n mako grantais, yn yma kawaith yna mae cyther eisiau. Nara sian tari yn yma kwa grantaisiau. In its totality, it is a oneness, it is a trifle, but it has layers. Da yw si yw'n mako gais yw'n mako grant. Let us take us to the layer of the jelly and the fruit that is suspended in the jelly. You may find that there are peaches, there may be grapes, there may be apple slices or oranges, there may be a plethora of fruit content within the jelly itself. But the jelly holds it there. It has a feeling of supporting, a feeling of being in and around the individual pieces in separation. And as you cut through and spoon out the trifle, you place it into a bowl, and as it drops into the bowl, the fruit dislodges from the comfort, from the jelly, and it may go into the mushy bit at the bottom, or the into the custard. So it moves and it distorts the form of the analogy. This is communication. So your little grape may end up in the top bit with a load of sprinkles on top. It's misplaced. It's not aligned. It isn't where it needs to be in its form, in its totality of self as a great big beautiful trifle sitting in a beautiful bowl. Yeah, now that's, yeah. So when you take it out of context and you place it in the bowl, the little tiny little red grape moves and it forms and goes into somewhere where it isn't needed to be. It doesn't need to be in the custard or the cream amongst all the sprinkles. But it does, and it gets misplaced. And with that communication, if you look at it, is that what happens is that the form is you. You are the grape. You are being supported by the universe, which is the jelly, and you are moving out into the emotional stage, which are the custards and the creams and the sprinkles. So when you communicate these things, sometimes it's misconstrued, sometimes it's distorted because it's coming from the head and the emotional state and not that of the heart. So if you stay in the heart, and when you spoon your trifle out into the bowl, it is placed beautifully in the bowl. It stays where it needs to be. It's perfectly set. The little grape is sitting right there, right in the jelly, and it's there being supported, and it's not moving until you take a nice bite. And it doesn't matter what the other person perceived the communication to be. That is their issue, that is their listening, that is their learning. But from your place, from your perspective, you know what you say from your heart fits right for you, and it is your experience that you're clearing your emotional states to get those communications over. But you learn and you experience, and the way you can then move into a clearer communication with other people around you is to actually come from here and say it with your hand on your heart. Say it from your hand on your heart, and it will be different. It will be so different. The information is coming from the heart and not that of the emotional states that are needed to be cleared within you, maybe a neediness or vulnerability or any other sort of emotional state that is being held within your energetic field that does need to go for your remembrance. And the universe always sends you what you need. And this information sort of came through this morning, sudden realizations. And yet, actually, my growth within my communication is still being tested along the way, and it will be, and it will always be, because that's the human experience. So everything is always going to be right. Whatever you say, whatever you do, it's always going to be right. But when we step into the heart space, it's clearer. There's more clarity. There's less distortion. Da, siama, kai wa siama tu de shi ki anda ta. Ana ma koya te de misho bai ni na ma ki. Da na ma shana ma ki e da. Though it's setting your intentions from the very beginning, from the heart space, that will enable the reality to unfold, the experience to unfold, to create that understanding and the allowance of the emotion to come forward. And with that, it allows it to clear. So the experience as a result of a miscommunication is always going to be right too, because it shows you what needs to be cleared within yourself. And it doesn't mean to say that your guides are guiding you down the wrong way. It's how you perceived the information coming through, how you perceived the experience that is being shown to you. It is not what they are intending. It is how you interpret it. And when people are misinterpreting from their perspective, that is about their journey. And that is nothing to do with you. That is nothing to do with you at all. That is about them being able to actually own what they say back or how they hear that information. Just like the distortion that is coming down from your inner guidance. So if people say things to you and they upset you in any way, shape or form, just allow yourself to see it from their perspective. Allow it to flow. Allow and see maybe a little bit of distortion if it's not coming from the heart space. And if it is coming from the heart, then see it from how you see it. And it's always going to be right for you again and again and again. So everybody in separation will hold their own truth, regardless of what it is. It always is going to be right. Okay, I hope that helps you on your journey. Check out all the details below with all of my online courses. If you want to sort of set up a mentoring session with me or a healing session to remove those really deep blocks, if you feel that you're having sort of restrictions, check out all my links below. Subscribe if you haven't done already. I'm just really excited on my journey that I'm uncovering and unveiling and understanding myself a little bit deeper as I go. And this sort of sense, and I knew about distortions and I knew about all this information, but I've got a bigger layer of understanding with that now. So as we go, we just understand it, a deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper understanding. Same subject, just going a little bit deeper. Okay, take care, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you all soon. Bye.